So here we have M.C. Escher's painting of a waterfall where the water is always flowing downward. And the book says that there must always be a curl of zero. But his paintings break this theorem by having a curl that does not equal zero, which if we visualize that as a paddle wheel, we can tell at any point the paddle wheel would be spinning, meaning that there is a curl greater than zero. And so that's how his paintings break this theorem.